Hey YouTubers, it's me, Monkey Dragon here, bringing you a custom class tips and tricks. I know I said I didn't want to do these until a week's out, but I feel that the game is so different that you guys may actually need some help. But anyways, let's go ahead and begin, guys. So I'm going to show you some of the custom classes that I've been using. This is currently the custom class that I have been currently using, and I think if you guys are going to start running what I'm running, this is just about where it's good. I'm having a great time running this class because of the time to kill on all those assault rifles. It's feeling like it's taking way too long at long range and the guns are kicking way too much. So I'm just running a semi-automatic sniper and then I have my pistols back up. So my custom classes are pretty much all going to be based on snipers because I don't like the assault rifles or subs in this game so far from the ones that I've used. So I've just been running around with my sniper rifle and it's been doing me just fine. I've been holding it 3KD or so about every game or so. And anyway, so I'll just get into a little bit. Hardline, I feel, because I always throw out UAVs every single time, and I feel that it's a lot better that if you just get it with the 3 kills, because you are going to be running the sniper rifle, so you're not going to be running out there getting amazing high kill streaks or whatever. And then fast hands is where you can switch to your pistol and you can climb and move over obstacles a lot faster, because as a sniper, your sniper rifle isn't really good for close quarters, so if you think a guy's coming, boom, hit triangle, boom, there's your pistol right then and there. And let's get into the pistol really quick. This is the pistol that I have been running. I barely unlocked this one, so I don't want to throw it into my custom class and guarantee that you guys is good. This one, I know for a fact, is a lot better than the 5.7. The TAC-45 is about a 2-hit kill pistol for me, and it is holding me just fine. I can take on guys with subs, shotguns, and assault rifles with it because I have me a pretty beast trigger finger. And the reason why I'm running long barrel and FMJ on this is because sometimes beyond 10 feet, you might get about 3-4 hit markers depending on what, if you accidentally bang through a surface or something, or you hit them on the body. So when I'm running this, I feel I get that 2-hit kill marker a lot more often than not. But once again, guys, like I always say in all my custom class and any tutorial, feel customized that you can change anything that you want in here. Personally, for me, I don't like the Ballista CPU. I do like the variable zoom. I have currently now unlocked all the way to FMJ on my sniper rifle. I have not unlocked the ACOG or the laser sight or any of these bottom three perks or attachments, my bad. I do have to say one thing though, fast mag, from my own personal experience, it's not worth it. Not worth it as an attachment. I'd rather have silencer or FMJ or something. It may just take away just a little bit of time, but it's not like the other Call of Duties where you reload, it takes you like 2 seconds, and then when you put on sled hand, boom, it's done in like a second. It's not like that at all. For the guns that I've used it on, it is not that big of a transformation. But I do have to say, I was just in private match using the dual band, and through the view of it, and I'll show you an image right here now of what it looks like. As you can see, it just changes the layout of it as a green view. And then if anyone walks through, they light up orange, which I'm actually liking. I would have hated it if it was in the old ones where everything was black and then the person is white like a phosphorus. But now that it's a night vision with a thermal scope to it, everything just is green lay. So you're not completely lost if you don't see an enemy. And I'm loving it so far. And since you really don't have to worry about people running cold blood or not, because even if they do, you'd still be able to see them because you're aiming down scope looking for a guy and you'll be able to see their name pop up. So I do like the dual band, although I haven't used it in online. I have used it in a private match and I am liking it. But once again, guys, the variable zoom, I like it over the Ballista. So you guys can always, you know, go ahead and take off, you know, gunslinger and then put something else on. If you guys like anything else different, then go on and change it. This is just for you guys. If you just want to start out, here's the classes that I'm using. And the reason why it's there is because I'm running around with a sniper rifle. And let's get on to the custom class that I would actually kind of want to use in the future. Because I love scavenger. I still want to have the sleight of hand because I am going to be focusing on that quick switch over to my pistol. And awareness, personally for me, is because I run a headset. And if you watch my previous video, I feel that the footsteps in the game, I can't even hear them. It's not even, they're not loud enough. I can't even hear them. So I want to test out awareness, although I have personally not used it yet. I feel that I'm going to need to use it. But once again, if you guys don't have a headset, go ahead and take it off. You can go ahead and throw on, you know, the dual band or whatever you prefer. Once again, guys, like I always say, change it up to the way you want it. But this is going to be the custom class that I am going to be using later on from my own personal experience. This is what I feel. And the reason, once again, why I want to have fast hands is because I want to switch between my pistol. And that's why. Anyways, guys, and this is what I'm going to be telling you really quickly, is if you want to go for a more defensive style sniper, more true to the actual sense, once again, I'm not going to recommend any bolt action snipers, because unless you're pretty accurate, I wouldn't use it. I'd rather personally know that I'm going to get two hits and have a semi-automatic sniper rifle where I can put those extra rounds in a lot faster just in case I accidentally miss. Because if you're running a bolt-action sniper, if you miss one shot, that can mean the life or death between you, your friend, objective, or taking out something. It could be a game changer. Believe it or not, guys, snipers are that important. So this is personally what I'm going to be running later on. Once again, the dual band. Personally, from using it in... I'm completely blanking. Private match. I personally like it. I find it a lot better than all the other scopes. FMJ obviously is not that big difference because you will be getting those two kills no matter what you put on it. Fast mag, not that relevant. And I'd rather have dual band over variable zone. And once again, guys, if you haven't already realized, this is the class I would like to run later on. Okay, I would like to also run hardline because before, hardline is pretty big because I like to get my lower end kill streaks. Just to get them in there and play a lot more defensively. Scavenger, this way I won't have to worry about, oh, my sniper's out, now I have to pick up a gun and then change my play style entirely. Sleight of hand, because this class is actually, is if you haven't already realized, it doesn't have a secondary. I know, a big shocker, right? This one is more focused on the sniper camping, and the reason why you're like, well, you don't have a secondary, why do you want the fancy? Yeah, I've already thought of that, guys, don't worry. Is because if you are playing camping, quote-unquote, as you can tell from the name, this is going to be the class, whereas if you get the kill with the claymore, you kill someone else, you can pick up their secondary. And since you're going to be picking up their primary, it's going to be a very fat or a very slow switch out. So you want fast hands because in this one, you're going to be picking up a primary. You're going to pick up the enemy's primary that you kill. That's the whole kind of goal here. And since there's a primary, it has a slow switch out. So you're going to definitely want the fast hands in order to have that quicker fit switch out. And once again, guys, me personally, because I have a headset and I cannot hear, It's not even a question of they're too low, I can't hear them. I cannot hear the enemy footsteps. I'm gonna be running awareness. Once again, for you guys, if you don't have a headset, then you can go in and take it off, go in and throw on another shot charge. This way you have that extra line of defense. And the reason why for scavenger is because obviously this way I can resupply my shock charges and my claymores. And if you guys don't already know, if you get a clear with the claymore or any other explosive, it's not gonna drop a scavenger pack. So just be wary of that. So you just wanna, you're gonna probably want your claymore as a backup and have your shock charges, if you choose to have this class as it is right here, as your primaries. This way you go, oh, there's a guy there. Lean out, boom, boom, get the kill. And then you can place a secondary claymore and get another shock charge back. Once again, guys, this class is as the name insists. It is obviously a camping class. So yeah, guys. Those are pretty much my three classes. If you're just gonna start sniping out, obviously use this class setup. This is the class setup that I wanna use later on, and this is gonna be more defensive sniper setup. So yeah, guys. So like the video if you liked it, subscribe to me if you wanna see more of my videos. I'm Monkey Dragon. That's all I got, guys. Peace.